seated. Ladies and gentlemen, we come today to celebrate and witness the union of two hearts and two lives together. As Cody and Lillian come to join their hearts together and begin a new chapter in their individual lives, and to begin the first chapter of their life together. And we have the joy and the privilege to share in this day with them. This is a very sacred time, not to be entered into lightly, but with reverence and discretion. As we talked about in my office, this is a covenant that you're entering into today, more than a contract between two individuals, more than a worldly commitment. This is a covenant relationship between you and God as you pledge your life to one another for the rest of your lives. We find in God's Word some very interesting things to be said about God's intent for marriage. The book of Genesis and the creation story, it says that the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he slept and he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in its place. Then the rib which the Lord God had taken from man, he made into a woman. And he brought her to the man, and Adam said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." I think it's interesting to note that God didn't take a bone from the foot of the man to indicate that the wife should be under him, or a bone from the back of man to indicate that she should be behind him. But he took a bone from the side to indicate that she would be not only a part of him, but a partner with him, and that the two of you should walk through the life that you live together side by side as partners. The Bible also tells us a lot about God's intent about the marriage relationship when it tells us that Christ performed his very first miracle at a wedding. It was there that he performed the wedding and changed the water into wine to help that couple have a successful and a happy start to their life together. The Apostle Paul, in writing about the marriage relationship, tells the husband to love his wife the way Christ loved the church and gave himself for the church. And he reminds us that we as husbands should be willing to even lay down our life for our spouse. He says to the wife that she's to be faithful to her husband in all things, that she's to be committed to him the way we as the church are committed to Christ. So, the Bible tells us what this covenant relationship involves, that we are pledging ourselves to one another for the rest of our lives according to God's plan. Being assured that there are no legal, moral, or religious barriers that hinder your proper union, I'm going to ask you now, Cody and Lillian, if you would, to join your right hands. And repeat after me. I, Cody. Take thee, Lillian.
Take thee, Lillian.
To be my wedded wife.
Be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
This day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
Now, Lillian, take thee, Cody. Wedding ceremony is a beautiful tradition behind it. Centuries ago, when a king, a czar, an emperor, or anyone in a position of power wanted to pass on their authority to another person, they did so by giving their signet ring. And so it has a way of exchange, it's a way of identifying with each other, a way of signifying your intent that you belong to each other, that you're committing yourselves to one another. The ring is a circle, a perfect circle without a seam, signifying God's intent that the love relationship be one that is unending. And then it's also made of untarnishable material, a symbol of fidelity and faithfulness that's intended in the marriage relationship. Cody, I'm going to ask you to take the ring. I'm going to ask you to place it on the third finger of her left hand. See if it helps. She's got a ring already there. It gives you a hint, doesn't it? Hold it there. Repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And all my worldly goods.
And all my worldly goods.
I give to thee. In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And